So, do you think you have an anger problem?
How far do you want to go?
A devoted wife, tired of standing by her shifty husband, is enraged when she is betrayed. Tyler Perry's new psychological thriller, Acrimony, hits theaters tomorrow.
Is the Oasis. It's a place where the limits of reality are your own imagination.
And playing now on the big screen is the action sci-fi adventure, Ready Player One. DirectConversations.com film critic Tim Lammers is here now with a review. Welcome back.
Thank you, Ellery. You know, Steven Spielberg, anytime you get him involved in a film, it's going to be great. What I like is the fact that he goes back and forth between different genres. He had the BFG, a kids movie, a couple of years ago. Now he's into the teen, early 20 demographic. Video gamers are going to love Ready Player One. Let's take a look.
The Oasis was the brainchild of James Halliday.
Hello. If you're watching this, I'm dead. I created a hidden object, an Easter egg. The first person to find the egg will inherit $500 billion and total control of the Oasis itself.
Who is this Parzival, and how the hell is he winning?
Great song there by Van Halen. Yeah. Jump. You're going to want to jump into Ready Player One. You have Ty Sheridan, you have Mark Rylance, Olivia Cooke, Ben Mendelsohn. You got a great cast in this movie, but a large part takes place in this virtual world where this gajillionaire has a $500 billion prize ready for anybody who can find out the clues and take the thing. But with a high-stakes game like that, things can get pretty deadly. So you have this fun video game sort of romp, but you also have this movie of intrigue. I like the movie, although I have to say, as a non-gamer, I felt like this is a lot to process. I think the big draw for people that aren't gamers is the fact that there's a lot of nostalgia in this picture, and that will be a big draw. I give this one 3 out of 4. Kid quotient, 2.5. I just think little kids might be a little confused by it, but I think it's a kid-friendly movie.
Yeah, and being Spielberg, that's a draw,
absolutely,
too.
Yes.
And some of it reminded me from the trailer of Minority Report,
too. Oh, absolutely. Very visually engaging.
Yeah, all right. Well, love movie swag? Text the word movie to 25543 for your chance to win this cool movie prize pack. It includes a pair of Fandango movie tickets, Ready Player One, the book, a fun bag, a T-shirt, and more. Now, Tim, out on DVD, digital, and Blu-ray is Star Wars The Last Jedi.
This was a divisive picture. Some people hated it. I loved it. Huh. Let's take a look. Oscar Isaac, a Porg, and you got Mark Hamill, lots of other people coming back. Unfortunately, Carrie Fisher's last screen appearance in The Last Jedi. Yeah. Again, I love this picture. I think it moved it along. It took it places probably people weren't going to expect. Of course, the DVD is, you know, you have all the extras involved with it. You have a director and the Jedi. It's a documentary. I think it's going to be a big hit, even if you didn't like the movie.
But you loved it.
I loved it, absolutely.
All right, and you said 3.5 stars.
Yeah, 3.5 stars for this one. Kid quotient again, 2.5. PG-13 movies. Little kids might be scared by the intensity, but boy, if you like Star Wars, you're really going to love this picture.
All right, and then let's chat about what's coming up next week.
Next week, we have a film called A Quiet Place with John Krasinski starring in it, directing it, writer, along with his wife, Emily Blunt, and it's a horror thriller.
Oh, all right. We're looking forward to that. Thanks so much for joining
us
again, Tim. All right. To see more of Tim's movie reviews, go to care11.com. We'll be right back.